This video series contains scientific and medical concepts aimed at informing healthcare professionals. Please note that the videos may contain visually stimulating images and movement.
The content of this video series focuses upon the unique and pathognomonic clinical entity of ME/CFS known as post-exertional malaise, or PEM. It is now widely accepted that many cases of long COVID or post-acute sequelae of COVID-19 meet the diagnostic criteria for ME/CFS and likely represent cases of ME/CFS triggered by the initial and persistent immune response to a COVID-19 infection. PEM and PESE, or post-exertional symptom exacerbation, are thought to be the same clinical phenomena and can be considered interchangeable for the purposes of these videos.
Post-exertional malaise is an entirely unique and pathognomonic finding in ME/CFS. This physiological phenomenon has yet to be documented in any other illness, absent even in those suffering post-chemotherapy complications or within the most physically decompensated of ill individuals. While the lack of a biomarker specific for the diagnosis of ME/CFS may seem to pose an impediment to accurate diagnosis, a careful history eliciting the presence of post-exertional malaise, or PEM, remains highly specific for this illness and occasionally sheds light upon perhaps the most essential and universal pathology uniting patients suffering with ME/CFS. The Institute of Medicine defines post-exertional malaise as an inability to recover normally following physical, cognitive or emotional exertion, resulting in an exacerbation of an individual's ME/CFS symptoms, leading to a reduction of functional ability that is more profound, more devastating, and longer lasting than observed in patients with other fatiguing disorders.
PEM is accompanied by a profound loss of stamina, reduction in functional capacity, and by augmented perturbations of ME/CFS pathophysiology, including worsening of autonomic dysfunction, metabolic efficiency, immune dysfunction, and aberrations in the HPA axis. Patients experiencing post-exertional malaise often describe an augmentation of flu-like symptoms, including subjective fevers, sore throats, myalgia, and arthralgia, worsening cognitive symptoms, including brain fog, difficulty with maintaining concentration, and word-fighting difficulties, worsening insomnia, headaches, increasing sensitivity to sensory stimuli, such as light or sound, and/or exaggerations of their abnormal cardiovascular responses to upright positioning, also referred to as orthostatic intolerance. It is not uncommon for those experiencing the symptoms of PEM to remain confined to bed for much of the duration of their episode, often so functionally limited that they struggle to complete simple activities of daily living, such as toileting or eating prepared food. Exertional triggers that can elicit post-exertional malaise can include exercise, orthostatic stress, cognitive or mental activities, environmental stressors, including bright lights or loud or multiple sounds, or chemical exposures, and even emotional triggers, including both excitement and joy, as well as stressful or negative emotional responses. In fact, the word exertion may undermine the fact that basic activities such as reading a book, using a computer, engaging in conversation, showering, or even sitting up to eat a meal can be sufficient to trigger an episode of PEM among particularly ill individuals.
This video was made possible by the OMF-funded Medical Education Resource Center at BHC, our generous donors, and viewers like you. Please consider making a tax-deductible donation to help keep educational resources like this one publicly available.